'Cause it's a new season. It's a new season. The old has passed away. The old has passed away. It's a new season. It's a new season. The old has passed away. The old has passed away. And I'm coming alive in you. I'm coming alive. Coming alive in you. I'm coming alive in you. Come on, let's just declare this. It's a new season. Yesterday is gone. It's a new season. The old has passed away. The old has passed away. Sing it out. It's a new season. It's a new season. The old has passed away. The old has passed away. It's a new season. Whatever was bothering you 5 minutes ago, 10 minutes ago, yesterday, today in the car on the way here, you gotta let that go. You gotta say it's a new season in the Lord. You gotta let it go, let it go. 'Cause I'm coming alive in you. I'm coming alive in you. I'm coming alive in you. Coming alive in you. I'm coming alive in you. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. And this is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. Alive. You make me come 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 alive. making all things new, and your light is breaking through the dark. Your love, it is sweeter than wine, bringing joy, bringing life, and your hope is rising like
the dawn.
And this is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. 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 It's always like springtime with you, making all things new, and your light is breaking through the dark. Your love, it is sweeter than wine, bringing joy, bringing life, and your hope is rising like
the dark.
And this is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. 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 You make me come alive.
You make me come alive.
Like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. Remember the first time you knew him, the first time. The first time you knew he was real, the first time, it's like I'm living for the first time. Finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. I'm finally living for the first time. And this is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. This is what you do, this is what you do. You make me come alive. You make come alive. You make me 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 come alive. just come alive. Oh, come alive. Come alive. Come alive. Come alive. Come alive. You make us come alive. Oh, yes. You make us come alive. Oh, you make us come alive. Oh, he makes us come alive. Come alive. Oh, oh, it's us. Come alive, come alive, come alive in me. Come alive, come alive, come alive in me. Whoa, come alive, come alive, come alive in me. Do a miracle in my heart, Lord. Come alive. Oh, yes. We were talking about miracles in Sunday school this morning, and if you weren't here, it was so good. There was such a, everybody just input. And there was the spirit of ministry just from one vessel to the next. And I just had this, like, you know, another miracle. Jesus called Lazarus out of that tomb. And I just see that the Lord is trying to do that this morning. He is just calling things that in Christ that we have let die. Some things you need to let die, and some things that you have in Christ he has given you that you've let fall away. And I just see that the Lord is saying, he's just calling to that thing that wasn't supposed to go. You know what I'm saying? Lazarus probably wasn't supposed to die, which was probably why he was made to come back. Think about that for a minute, right? So just for me, when I'm up here singing this, I'm just singing it. I'm hearing the voice of God, but I'm singing it over my own life. You know, come alive, come alive. You're just calling it to that inner voice, the Holy Spirit that he has given you. And you're saying, come alive, come alive. And if you can just declare that over yourself, come alive, come alive. Oh, yes. Come alive, come alive. Come alive in me, come alive in me, Lord. Come alive in me, come alive in me, come alive in me. Whoa. Whoa.
other thing that was mentioned in Sunday school is that when you look at all the miracles did, I'm going to say this because there's more people in the room, I feel like more people should have heard what happened in Sunday school this morning, but when you think, if you're wanting a miracle, then you need, if you look at all the miracles that happened in the Bible, and we talked about this morning in Sunday school, and Brother Danny said it again during offering, is that you need to look at it from the position those people were in. Okay? So we talked about the woman with the issue of blood. She bled for 12 years. She had no other hope. There was nothing else that could fix her. The only thing that could fix her was Jesus. That was it. That was the only thing that could fix her situation. And yet she had to push through all of the obstacles in the crowd to get down to touch his garment. She didn't even reach for his hand, his head, nothing. She got down to the very bottom of who he was, on her face, on her hands, on her knees. And only then did she receive the miracle. So I just encourage, God is doing something because he just keeps prompting here. He keeps prompting right here. If you need something, do not wait for him. He's here. He's here this morning. You need to do something. And it's got to be something right in here, right in your heart. That's the only way. That's the only way. And I'm telling you, he is doing something in this place today. He really is. He is pressing and pushing because he will never give up on us. He will never, ever give up on us. So he is pressing and he is pushing into this thing where we need to come to the end of us. And that's what happened with all those miracles. That is the point of what I'm saying. We, all those people, to accept their miracle had to come to the very end. There was no other hope for that woman with the issue of blood. And if there is anything that anyone is struggling with this morning, whether it be emotional or physical, if you want to prompt yourself, if you want to position yourself for a miracle, then you have to come to the end of it and say that Jesus Christ is the only hope for every issue in my life. That's it. There is no other hope. There's no other hope for Christ Life Fellowship. There's no other hope for us as a church, and there's no other hope for us individually. We have got to do this together. Yes. So now the question always is, we get to this awkward moment in worship, where do we go from here? We heard the call. Here's the thing, in that awkward moment, you can hear the call, but then you have to decide whether or not you're going to answer the call of God, okay? So we're going to open up the altar. We're going to switch songs. If you feel the Holy Spirit is pressing on you to go pray somebody for or encourage somebody, then we need to do that this morning. We need to do that this morning. And there needs to be no awkwardness, no pressure. You know, the only pressure that should come is from the Lord. And if you're feeling his pressure, then that's the you need to respond accordingly to what's in your heart. But I'm sensing he's just calling and calling and calling. So we're going to switch. We're going to switch songs. We're going to go to the last one. Again, let's not have church as usual today.
I had brought this up in Sunday school, but if anybody here, we want to believe in our head we say it, but if there's anybody that has doubt that Jesus can do these miracles and would do them for you, there was something in the miracles that the demons had no doubt whatsoever. They walked right up to Jesus and said who he was, what was he doing there, was it before his time, are we going down? They didn't have any doubt, and if they didn't have any doubt and they knew who he was, we should have no doubt that he wants to do it for us.
That's true. And the truth is that he is here right now. He can meet every single need. You are here with us, Emmanuel. You are here. You are here with us, Emmanuel. You are here. You are here with us, Emmanuel. You are here. And you are here with us, Emmanuel. You are here. When I touch you. When I touch you, I know you make me whole. When I touch you, my faith has been restored.
Thank you. praise. You are my song. And when I think of you, I fall in love. Your word is true. It brings me strength. And when I read of you, I fall in love. I fall in love.
Come and bow, come and bow on through.
What the Lord's been doing in you. And I just want to encourage you that this place, filled with all these people, is a safe haven for you. Let me just share something for a minute. I can really relate to this young man, you know. When you grow up and you have the perfect depiction of light and darkness around you, you have those around you that bring you light, and that you have those around you that are in darkness, and you, the Holy Spirit takes a hold of that thing, and he'll bring discernment at a young age, because you can see the line. You see the light and you've seen the darkness. And I want to tell you, is it okay if I share with you what your prayer request from a few weeks ago? Okay. Do you want to share it? Yeah, tell them what you want to do.
For my mom and Dad. I want them to come to church, Dad to come back to church, and my mom, who never, I don't think she ever went to church. I want her to come. I want them both to come to heaven.
You know, and he tore me apart when we were out there with all the kids, because this is what he said. He said, I just want my dad to stop doing what he's doing. You know, we won't say what the things are, but he's like, I just want him to stop doing the things that he's doing. When you're 12 years old and you look at your parents and you say, I want them to stop doing what they're doing. You know, in most cases, it's the other way around. Aiden, just know that the Lord is with you. He is with you. You continue to choose the light every single time. And he is going to take over your life in ways that you never even thought were possible. Okay? Guess what? Auntie had a perfect depiction of light and darkness when I was growing up, too. And I'm going to tell you what. The light is so awesome. It's so amazing. There's nothing that can fill your life like Jesus can. He loves you. He loves you more than your parents love you. He loves you more than your mind and your heart can even comprehend. And when you feel sad and when you feel scared and when you don't know what to do, cry out to him. And when you come into this place, it is a safe haven. With Brother Tim and Sister Sandra, it's a safe haven. With your friends, those are safe havens for you. Well, there's one more thing. They started singing the song, Spirit Come Blow Through. And Aiden, I know you're not baptized yet, but I really do feel like the Lord wants to fill you up right now. Yep. Yeah. Yep. And listen, if there is anybody else in this room that wants a fresh touch from the Holy Ghost, and, you know, I keep hearing it for young people, if you're 12 and under, if you're 12 and older, I mean, it's for anybody, but I really heard that. For our young people, if you want to, we're going to continue to lay hands on the seed in this house. Continue and continue. And if you want a fresh touch of the Holy Spirit this morning, let's lay hands. Let's lay hands. Let's pray in the Spirit. We're just going to have them come sing. And if you want a fresh touch of the Holy Ghost, just come up here, raise your hands, whatever it is. Those around us can pray. But I'm telling you, it's here. It's here right now.
Yeah. come and move. We're ready for you, so come and move.
I keep hearing there's more little kids in here. And parents, just maybe you want to just ask them if they want to come, or if they come on their own, that's fine, but laying hands on them is so important. God's Spirit, we're ready for you to blow
on through.
Break our walls down. I keep hearing the Spirit say, seasons like this, so the Lord can get to our heart, get to our ear, and cause us to get a hunger for Him. But I keep hearing this word over and over again. There's nothing that'll cause the Spirit of God to work in your life like hunger, like passion, like desire. And I keep hearing the Lord say for every one of us that He's working on us so that we will get desire. We'll move things out of the way, thoughts, attitudes, stuff, so that we get a greater hunger, a greater passion for Him. It's beyond imagination what God wants to take us into. So I challenge every one of us in this room today, hear the voice of the Lord today. He's saying, get hungry. Get hungry for God. Get hungry for His ways. Get hungry for His purposes. The only way we're going to move forward in Him is that we get a hunger to have more of Him. There's no end to God. There was no beginning in Him, and there was no end in Him. And His challenge is to every one of us, come up higher, come up hither, come into a dimension where you can get more of God than what you're experiencing now. It isn't that He's holding back on you or me. It's that we just don't desire to experience all there is of Him. He's already here. Came today in a new dimension, a new way. I was just thinking the scripture that we had started the year out with, is let us go on. Let us move forward. We got to go beyond where we're at. Every one of us, myself included, I got to move on. There's more to God to experience. There's more to God to know. There's more of Him. Because if you step from this life into the next, you still got to go on. You got to know Him. It's not automatic. It's a process of knowing. So I challenge everybody in the room tonight, today. Challenge every one of you. Get a hunger. Get a passion. Get a desire to move forward. You got to get a hold of more of God than what you're experiencing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I praise you, God, today. Thank you for this day. Thank you, God. I thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, worship team. Thank you for obeying God. Thank you, Lord.